Stranglehold is a total hidden gem from the last generation of consoles as well as PC from a little over a decade ago, and it didn't really go down in history as anything super special, but those who really got a chance to play it all the way through generally enjoyed their time with it. Using the Unreal Engine 3, Stranglehold produced some pretty slick action sequences for the time that were clearly inspired by cheesy Hong Kong action movies, which should come as no surprise as the main mind behind it was John Woo, the Chinese film director, writer, and producer who was known for Hard Target, Broken Arrow, as well as some American work he did on 90s classics like Face Off and the Mission Impossible series. The reason I bring up his filmography, of course, is because the game Stranglehold isn't just inspired by his work in film, but it is actually a reimagining of one of his more successful breakout movies, Hard Boiled. As might have been expected, John Woo's style made a very stylish and amusing transition to the video game format with some great levels that were clearly designed to be jumped through in slow motion while mindless enemies stood out in the open welcoming your bullets right into their faces. The comparisons to Max Payne might feel obvious and obligatory, but not so fast, as the creators of Max Payne openly admit that they were originally influenced by Woo films first. Funny how that works out. Inspiration is definitely a two-way street. Nevertheless, once Stranglehold was done, it was received pretty well and earned many above-average scores for its over-the-top action, fast-paced story, and fun characters, and an overall package that was a blast to play, yet didn't overstay its welcome. The short and sweet approach was definitely the way to go for this game, and there were immediate plans for a sequel. Midway was moving forward with pre-production, and Chow Yun-Fat was more than ready to reprise his role as the main character, so things were looking good. According to a few sources, Vin Diesel was going to also play a role in the game to help with some mass appeal in the West. And the game was going to have a two-character buddy cop story structure, which seemed like a great direction to go for the sequel. Many mechanics were formed around the concept of two cops who were different but had similar goals, and things were going along very smoothly on the technical end, with some very decently playable alpha segments emerging from the development team very quickly. Despite all of this, the world would never see a finished Stranglehold 2, and as of July 2018, there's still no official word on if we ever will. But why not? Why did a sequel to a great game with so much talent and potential behind it never surface? Why did this franchise die before it even got a chance to truly live, while so many games that were much worse became long-running franchises? What the hell happened to Stranglehold? As with a lot of video game projects around the later years of the first decade of the new millennium, developers were finding out that video game production was getting much more expensive. Many developers and publishers didn't adapt well to this, and Midway evidently was one of those, as they were finding themselves in debt to the tune of millions and millions of dollars, while Stranglehold 2 Gunrunner was in the early stages of production. Despite having a better sales projection than the first game, the decision was eventually made to pull the plug on the project relatively early on, which is very unfortunate as the game was shaping up quite nicely, and according to some footage that can now be found on the internet, Stranglehold 2 Gunrunner was going to feature some pretty nice destructibility that would have been nice to see once texture mapping was applied. The footage that can be found might remind one of Just Cause 3, way before Just Cause 3. Alas, the world would never get to see this happen. Midway tried to restructure the game, dropping the Stranglehold name altogether and just calling it Gunrunner, but even that proved to be too much to bear for the financially strapped studio. Much of the concept art can be found as one of the lead artists on the project released it to add to his resume a few years ago. The more you look around at the footage and art that has come out from the team's work on Stranglehold 2, the more disheartening you may feel about the fact that it never came out, as it really was an impressive amount of work to get done in such a short amount of time. One can't help but think about how great the game could have turned out if it were given all of the time and resources that are normally afforded to a full-fledged video game. Whatever the future does hold for the franchise that didn't quite get to become a franchise, hopefully we can see another serious attempt get off the ground someday. Over-the-top action will never totally go out of style, and with today's sensibilities, where many gamers yearn for the days of a simpler, more stylish take on action and are just plain sick of the slow, brooding characters of the past several years, I think there's a rather large gap that a game like Stranglehold 2 could fill quite nicely. Whether the next game to fill that void is Stranglehold 2, Max Payne 4, or something else entirely, I think that while we may not know about Stranglehold 2 Gunrunner ever rising from the dead, surely the future of stylish action games is something that any serious game developer should consider investing in. Fans of games like like the original Max Payne and Stranglehold are still out there, and they now have even more disposable income to spend on games than they did 10 years ago. So, no matter what you want to call it, there's definitely room for a new game of this type. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching us here at Gaming Bolt. If you enjoy our content, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification icon so you'll know when new videos are up.